Morning, everybody. Let's take a deep breath, inhale three, and exhale all our stress. Let's do it once more. Please inhale three, exhale. Please breathe in all the blessings of the Buddha and heal ourselves, our mind, our delusion. Please inhale fully. Exhale. Then please take a one moment. Our past is past, is gone. Is not here, and future is not yet here. On this moment, it doesn't stay in 1 second. It's just going through moment. So all our concern for peace and happiness is just this moment. Because past is whatever we have, good or bad life, is gone. It's just in the memory. And the future is not yet come here. The peace or happiness, whatever you are dreaming for. And this very moment, of the peace, happiness is passing through. This very moment of sufferings is going through. So this is the how reality, nature itself is. So this moment, mind, if we could maintain just this moment, that is subscale, uncontrived. So we just relax, just to just be in that. Just this moment. Without being uptight, but be spacious, free from So this this last few days and today, my presentation is just a simple the try to express the Buddha's wisdom. So whatever I said that just mentioned, you investigate, you understand. So if you can make, if you can say, so what I said is, if you feel it makes sense, it is kind of acceptable, keep in the mind, hold practice. This is daily practice you should do. Not something practice somewhere, some close somewhere. Whatever I spoke here, just apply in your daily life. That's the practice, you see. Because some people ask me, can you give us some special practice? See, all I am talking is how to practice. understand, make sure you understood, and then put into practice. So, if you mind. Now, anyhow, today we got this day. So fortunate having this precious human life. As I mentioned, this precious human life has such a great opportunity. Not other life, animals, no? Animals or anything they can do, we can do much better than anybody else. So precious human life has that kind of great opportunity, special gifts of the mental capacity. And then to take advantage of this precious human life. There are so many things to do, as I mentioned, but the Buddha's teaching, the wisdom that Buddha has given us out of great compassion, is the something that makes very decisive. What is suffering and what is the cause of suffering? What is happiness and what is the cause of happiness? Not just from outside phenomena. If you get a house, you'll be so happy. If you get a car, you'll be so happy. Not that much. More so in the mind. We all have the mind. And because of that, we think so much. But sometimes we forget the importance of the mind. We just, our attention is so much on the outside, to fixing outside. If you fix this, your life will be better. If you fix this, and you will have, you know, more happiness. Instead of bringing the mind back into inside, how if you keep your mind in this way, and this is how the peace or happiness can produce. If our mind goes that direction, then the suffering, suffering may produce. So that kind of wisdom the Buddha has fully captured, enlightened, and spoke about this. So that's why it's not just a religious training, as I mentioned a few times. It is something practical approach. That practical approach can be universal if we have interest. So that's why I have mentioned this. We're so fortunate. We're so fortunate that we have the Buddha nature, as I spoke of. That Buddha nature, see, can understand what Buddha spoke from his enlightened Buddha nature. That's why I say we should all appreciate. Because it's mentioned, we all desire to free from suffering. There's no question about it. We all desire for peace and happiness. There's no any question about it. We all agree about that. But then, how to do these things? There's so many methods, so many steps we take, because the mind is such a complex subject. That's why Buddha, basically we know of the term, three wheel of the Dharma teachings. The first wheel. First he spoke about the Four Noble Truths. Foundation of the Buddhist teaching is the foundation. Then after that, he spoke about the Mahayana teachings, especially emptiness teachings. Emptiness is not something making empty, but how things constitute within empty causality state. And that causality state means interdependent. All are related, interconnected, depend on each other. Yes. So when we are more advanced, then you see these things more. Then at the end, Buddha spoke, every sentient being has the Buddha nature. Sometimes they call it mind only school. It's not just mind only school, it is the interpretation of the ultimate potential we have. That every sentient beings can become Buddha. Because everyone has that seed. Just for example, when we plant the rice or corn, every corn seed has the potential to grow as corn. So look at this. So Buddha spoke this wisdom without any reservation. Totally spoke complete way. So one individual can attain complete Buddhahood. But we have to make effort. We have to work hard ourselves towards this direction. With great joy, I have been suffering something for a long time. There's no any way how to get out of this. I just continued in the delusion, one after another, working hard. Now today, I got this wisdom to open the door, how to end of the suffering. This is a joyous effort. As mentioned, it's not just something, a religious training, but it's the training. training make our mind to see things reality actually as it is. For example, impermanent. All the things that composite on the base of many causes and conditions, that all things can change. Nowadays it's easier, as other day mentioned, the scientists, quantum physics theory, and they all agree, even the hard, rocky mountain looks like very solid. Now they put it so fragile and keep changing. So that's without our understanding, that's the reality nature. So like this, it's universal. So Buddha's teaching is we should see as a universal method how to free from suffering and how to have peace and happiness. And within this, the mind is the center or working place. We should know that I have the every opportunity, and if I make effort, I have the every opportunity and ability to do this. And then start that way, joyfully follow the path. So then see that way, we individually, we can get real peace within us. Because Buddha nature is the absolute peace. No matter what happens to the world, when you could capture the Buddha nature, you have got everything what you need. So this first we every day we start, especially from today. Now this day, so I'm so fortunate. So I got this opportunity.
今天早上，卢布杰大体是讲到，就是起先呢，就是还没有开始之前呢，我们应该了解到，好像我们所讲的三心不可得，过去心不可得，现在心不可得，未来心不可得。所以刚才就是听说一下，就是那些已经过去的事情过去了，也不要去想它、执着它，未来的还没有到来。都可能还会在变化，当下每一个时候呢，每样东西你在想的时候，它也在一直在跑动着，所以呢，我们应该把那个心放在当下，不造作，静静的放松静坐，然后也不要说很紧张这样，然后在不造作的境界之中，慢慢把心调好。过后我们就讲说，前几天呢。讲的都是重点，就是佛陀的智慧，也就是佛法。然后听闻那个佛法之后呢，自己要研究分析明白了它。然后如果就讲，如果你觉得他所讲的是对你有益的话，你就接受，然后把它在日常生活里面用于日常生活。所以有一些人有问仁不济说，仁不济你可以给我一些特别特别的法来修吗？其实仁不济说他这几天讲的那个法就是很重要的法，主要在佛法里面的学习是闻思修，这个就是真正的修行。然后今天仁不济讲，我们很幸运得到这个暇满人生，我们有这个机会呢，能够好好的去修持，去了悟自己的心性。我们比其他六道的众生好得多，我们比畜生道好得多， 因为我们有这种这样的智慧，在六道里面，人是有那种智慧可以思考问题，在苦乐参半的境界里面，运用这个人生呢，有机会接触佛法，就好好修行佛法。所谓修行佛法，就修佛陀的智慧，来启发自己本有的智慧。然后，当你能够了解这一点的话，你自然而然呢，就会升起慈悲心，你就会知道慈悲心是这么的重要。然后，在这个思考问题里面，有讲到你就会开始问什么是苦，既然娑婆是苦，做什么会有这个苦，它的原因在哪里，什么叫做是真正的快乐，永恒的快乐，怎么样才能够做到有真正的快乐，所以要知道它的原因。然后一般上来讲，凡夫一直觉得要真正的快乐，就要去享受荣华富贵，世间上很多那些享受品，物质的享受，其实人生并不只是这样子罢了。我不去讲，很多时候呢，我们也要好好的关照自己的内心，烦恼，内心的烦恼妄念种种，把那个心的妄念烦恼降伏下来。所以很多时候呢，我们没有关照我们自己的心啊，我们忘记其实我们本有的清净心是这么的珍贵，这么的重要。我们很多时候呢，心整天是向外攀援，所以很多时候都不看不到自己这样珍贵的一个清净心。所以这边仁波切讲，我们时常应该内照，好好的去修那个心，然后从心的了悟之后呢，能够真正达到永恒的快乐。只是追求外面的物质享受，很多时候呢，都造业，最后的后果呢，我们是自作自受，就受到痛苦。所以我们应该学习佛陀的智慧。佛陀就是因为看到这一点，把重点讲出来，所以呢，所讲的这些佛法呢，其实并不是宗教，就是说你是佛教出人才相信，其实这个呢是每一个人都应该正视到的，因为这个是切身的问题，你可以当作是一个宇宙的真理，有这个机会能够学习到，我们感到很庆幸。做什么呢？因为我们本身都本有这个清净心，或者我们称作佛性或者如来藏，然后这个所谓的清净心，有这种这样的种子的这个如来藏，我们就有这种的智慧，一定能够最终了解到佛陀所讲的全部的法，就是佛陀的智慧，然后我们一定能够离苦得乐，也就是能够大彻大悟成佛。一点很重要的我们要知道是，所有的人都不希望得到痛苦，都希望能够离苦得乐，每一位众生都是如此，大家应该是同意这一点的。不管你是外道或者佛教徒，每一个人都是希望能够有永恒的快乐。所以另一个问题就是怎么样子去寻求这个真正的快乐呢？当然方法很多，最主要是这个心是相当的复杂，你唯有运用佛法才真正能够了悟到本有这个的清净心。所以在佛陀他转法轮的时候，三转法轮的时候，第一转法轮就讲到四圣谛的苦集灭道为基础，然后第二转法轮就讲到大乘佛法里面的空性的比较深奥一点的佛法，怎么样子很多万物都离不开那个因缘和合，都离不开那个因果律。然后呢，从这一点呢，再更了解到一切都是缘起，因缘和合而成，没有一个所谓的单独的一样东西能够有它本身的一个很独立的一个自信的体，每一个都是 万物都是全部因缘聚合才形成一样东西，都是息息相关的。然后到最后呢，在第三转法轮的时候，佛陀再讲出来，就是其实每一个众生都有佛性，也就是有成佛的宗旨，所以这方面的佛法是非常非常的重要。因为呢，你了解它的时候呢，你就有很大的潜在力，能够突破，能够还原，还归回你，找回你本有的清净心，或者是我们讲的般若智慧，或者是佛性。所以我们既然有这个开悟的种子，所以一定能够成佛。打个比喻说，如果你要拿到那个玉米，你只要有它种子种出来的，一定是能够有这个玉米。所以佛讲到他大彻大悟之后，就讲到这方面的智慧，他没有说自私的不把全部讲出来，他无私心，心量很大的，把这个非常深奥的道理呢公布于世，希望每个人都能够学习，而且能够真正得到修行，真正得到快乐。所以我们既然知道有这样珍贵的佛法，就应该珍惜这个人生，珍惜这个机会呢，好好的精进学佛，直到我们成佛为止。所以我们应该修持佛法有一个心态，就是觉得很感恩能够听到这个法，第一点。第二点呢，就是很活泼和充满喜悦的心态呢，去好好的学习佛法。我们应该这样想，你不觉得说，就是说无始以来我们已经生生死死一直流转到现在为止，在迷惑的境界中，有很多时候我们都一直在寻找快乐，但是在寻找中到现在还是在这个轮回里面。所以到今天呢，既然我有这个机会听闻这个佛陀的智慧的法，所以现在就是我们打进佛门的第一步。怎么样讲呢，就是你就是开了那个门呢，进去呢是要去除你所面对的全部的痛苦，了悟自己本有的信心。所以呢，你在修持佛法里面那个心态呢，应该是高高兴兴的去学佛。然后这个这样子的修持呢，最主要是修心，这个复杂的心修到最后呢，一层一层的你了悟本有的清净心。打个譬喻，我就讲说，我们讲佛法里面所讲的无常，很多时候我们知道万法的显现呢都是因缘和合，也就是因缘和合的关系呢，所以它无常，时常在变。尤其是现在科学家呢，在他们的那种研究里面，到最后他也是同意这个观点，所以很多东西都是因缘和合。就讲一个山，你看看高山里面很多大石头，其实这高山时常都在一刹那一刹那之间的变动，它不是永恒的在那边不动的。所以从这一点你就可以看到，从无常里面这个山也是相当脆弱，它不能原原本本的不动，它每一块石头每一块大石种种的都在那个大自然里面时常都出现变动。所以这些呢就是无常，这些呢就是整个宇宙的真实现象。所以我们就应该知道这个佛法呢，其实它所讲的是每一个人都应该去学习的，是一种正确的方法，希望每一个众生都能够离苦得乐，不只是佛教徒，也包括其他宗教外道或者没有信仰的人都应该学，因为这个是切身的问题。所以我们有这个心，我们有这个机会，有个机会听闻佛法，我们就知道怎么样觉得自己很幸运能够佛有机会听闻佛法，然后一定要好好的去修，然后最后呢 你一定得到真正的快乐。所以真正快乐使你能够安宁的快乐源泉呢，就是你达到了悟你自己的如来藏或者你本有的佛性。当你了悟到你本有这个佛性或者清净心的时候，其实你已经不缺任何东西了，你已经拿到全部全部的东西。所以我们应该以这种心态感恩觉得自己这样幸运能够听闻佛法。从现在我们就开始讲课来听，继续听这个佛法，以这种心态来听。
On these few days, we are reflecting on the special book, Precious, or the Nature of the Wisdom that I put into a small booklet by the great master, Kampopa. And that book is called The Jewel Ornament of Liberation. So we're just reflecting on this. So last few days we talked about the remedy for the attachment of this life, a remedy for the attachment of the samsara. Because if we have attachment to this life or in the samsara, then we cannot go farther. We just stay there, and then cannot accomplish as much that as we want to, because we're stuck there, we're entangled there. So to break that entanglement, then we should see the reality nature of this life, attachment to this life, and attachment to samsara. So that's the purpose. It's not making things are bad, but how we are constituted in such kind of condition. Use the wisdom. And then, for the individuals, liberations who are interested to that, to make that mind broad, to know that liberation is not just one individual person. Liberation is required by all the sentient beings. To get that understanding, then Buddha talked of the love and compassion. Basically, as I mentioned, since we have the Buddha nature, the seed of love, the seed of compassion is there. It's not religious belief. Some people say, practicing loving kindness is something spiritual thing. No. So, like, say, for regular individuals, like, say, no need